for us.
All right, what's up?
To change, sort of a change of pace, we're in our opening act for the Video Music Awards, which starts at 6:30. We're going to have Smash Mouth and Blink are going to be there playing. But we also have the first interview, television interview, with Trent Reznor of Nine Inch Nails that he's done in like 5 years. Cool. It's very interesting. He has this album coming out. It's a double album called The Fragile. And it's the most amazing thing. It's just an incredible...
You have it?
I don't have it.
But you've heard it.
I've heard it.
Somehow Kurt Loder, I mean, I know your friends were like, he listened to Madonna like a year before it came out. So have you sat down with both CDs and like...
I'm over that record now.
Oh, you are?
I'm on to the...
Thank God,
by
the way. Yeah. Can I just tell you, that was annoying me every day hearing Ray of Light, so...
Well, yeah, it was a great record. But anyway, this is a great record, too. And for those who, I mean, some of your viewers may not even remember, it's been so long since Trent and Nine Inch Nails were around, we have a little look back right now.
Cool.
When industrial rock arose in the 1980s with bands like Einstürzende Neubauten, Test Department, Ministry, and Skinny Puppy, it was kind of a junkyard genre filled with jackhammer beats and the sounds of collapse and breakage. Trent Reznor, a one-time classical piano student from small-town Pennsylvania, introduced a synthesized symphonic grandeur to the form and an obsessively introspective, sometimes disturbing lyrical style. Reznor and his road rat band Nine Inch Nails, boosted by their powerful performances on the first Lollapalooza tour, went platinum with their 1989 debut album, Pretty Hate Machine, and their 1992 follow-up, Broken, although it was only an EP, sold strongly enough to make it a top 10 hit on the album chart. Since 1995, when Nine Inch Nails released its last album, The Downward Spiral, not a whole lot has been heard from Reznor, apart from his occasional scoring projects for film directors Oliver Stone and David Lynch, and of course his key role as a producer in launching Marilyn Manson into the big time with the multi-platinum Antichrist Superstar album. Now Reznor and Nine Inch Nails are back, as we said, with a spectacular double album due out on September 21st called The Fragile, a collection of some of the most awesome new sounds and enormous riffs you've heard in quite a while. And you can find out more about it in Trent Reznor's first TV interview in 5 years, as we said, airing exclusively on the opening act pre-show leading up to the MTV Video Music Awards this Thursday night starting at 6:30 p.m. Will you be there, Carson?
Yes, I will.
Good.
All day, all night.
I'll be there with
all
you.
The time.
It'll be fabulous.
Thank you, Kurt. And we also want to mention we're waiting for the video to be edited, the first
yes.
single. So hopefully we'll have that on this show, maybe even tomorrow. That'd be cool.
Tonight, and they have a remarkable double album called The Fragile finally coming out on September 21st, less than 2 weeks hence. After listening to it straight through, we sat down for a talk with Reznor himself recently and found him, well, maybe not chipper exactly, but definitely ready to make a whole new kind of noise.
We went from being a fairly medium, small band to a lot bigger. And when you have that many people around you kissing your ass that much for that long a time, and then it's time to return to normal life, that's always the problem I've had. When the tour is over, getting back to a place where you can create music. It was time to start a new record, and I didn't really want to do it, so I found myself procrastinating and I found myself taking on small projects.
One of those little projects turned into an unexpectedly big deal, producing the multi-platinum Antichrist Superstar album, the breakthrough hit for Reznor's proteges in the Florida industrial band Marilyn Manson.
When that finished, it was kind of some weird things started happening, and I really found myself in a kind of bad place.
What happened?
Some friendships dissolved at the completion of that record. And
you had a falling out with the Manson people?
Yeah, basically.
The beautiful people.
I was really, really unhappy. And I was really disillusioned with a lot of things, and I didn't trust anybody. I wasn't sure what I wanted to say musically, and so I didn't. I thought rather than put a record out that was unfocused mess, I wasn't really ready as a person. I was dealing with death of someone very close to me.
Your grandmother, huh?
Yeah, who raised me. And I didn't deal with it. I just put it off because I didn't know how to deal with it. No one ever died around me.
Attempting to kickstart himself out of the depression that followed his grandmother's death in 1997, Reznor took on another side project, remixing a track for his pal David Bowie. As it turned out, his paranoid state of mind at the time also inspired the song's eventual video.
Oddly, at the time, I was on a kick of watching Taxi Driver. For some reason, I'd always, at the end of the night, I'd put that on, and, you know.
Really?
I think
I was cheery.
I was losing it then and there. This is right in the time where it's like, what am I going to do? I'll just watch Taxi Driver again. Maybe that'll make me feel better, and it didn't. I don't recommend that anybody do that.
Probably not.
I'll take my place.
like psychotherapy or anything? Or
I did for a while, actually. Thing?
Was it helpful?
It was helpful in some ways, and in some ways it wasn't. I mean, generally, yes, but I reached a point where I said, I just want to deal with things on my own terms. Yeah. And I'd rather not get too in detail on that, but basically came out with an explanation of kind of why you felt the way. Hey, you're depressed.
Yeah.
Oh.
On top of his personal torments, Reznor started feeling pressure from fans and critics to create a new album that would shake up the dull and cheesy music scene of the late 90s.
And all during this time, I'm getting, please come save rock. I didn't ask to save rock. I don't even like rock that much. So really at about one time, and this is about 2 years ago, I really said it was time to get going. Came down to really just sitting down and facing myself again and remembering that playing music was what always saved me in the past and made me feel like I had something to offer.
For 2 years, Reznor holed up in his high-tech New Orleans studio, conjuring brutal new riffs and exotic new sounds, and occasionally creating whole choirs out of some locals he'd corralled in from nearby watering holes.
Who were all the singers on here? Did you just pick them out of the neighborhood? Or?
Yeah, it would typically go like 11 o'clock at night, we'd figure, we need some people to yell something. So we'd just empty the bar across the street, and then a bunch of drunk guys come in and, mumble really? Something. And I think we assembled the most atonal group of females I've ever heard. Like, I hope they're not watching this right now. It's comically horrendous.
So you got the Video Music Awards, you get a chance to meet all these people. Maybe you can meet Britney Spears and the Backstreet Boys.
Yeah, maybe.
Are you friends with the Korn, Limp Bizkit people at all?
I know some of the guys in Korn, and I think they're cool guys. I don't know any of the other guys.
Yeah. And you don't know Britney or Backstreet Boys, I'm sure.
No.
This could be an interesting evening for you, I'd imagine.
Getting better all the time, Trent Reznor of Nine Inch Nails, whose new album, The Fragile, has to be some kind of landmark of sonic architecture, as they probably say. The band will, of course, be performing live tonight on The Big Show. John, how much fun are you having out there?
Someone I gather understand you're looking forward to meeting tonight is Trent Reznor. You're a fan?
Trent Reznor, Nine Inch Nails. I'm a huge fan, so I'm looking forward to that performance.
Great. Going to be awesome. Have a great night, okay?
Nine Inch Nails, go.
Should be awesome, right?
Yeah, that should be awesome.
Talk to him earlier.
And Trent says he's feeling better these days, so... happy. Kind of happy.
Kind of happy, right?
The album sounds great. I love his new album. It's brilliant.
Nine Inch Nails.
One of the highlights of Thursday night's Big Show was the first performance in years by Nine Inch Nails, a band that finally has a new album coming out on September 21st called The Fragile. We sat down to have a talk with head nail Trent Reznor recently, and here's some of what he had to tell us.
I won't let you
It's been so long since we put a record out. I mean, a lot has changed since then.
True.
So I really don't know what to expect in terms of how it fits in here. Are we still cool? Or is it this taken over? And if I think too much about it, I kick right back into what can be very stifling. So again, I just trust my instinct of what worked in the past is always what seemed right to me. I mean, if Downward Spiral is kind of a descent into peeling off layers in madness, ultimately, and ending that record in a very kind of bleak spot. Fragile starts there and is almost more about repair.
I think you could say We're in This Together and The Fragile are like love songs, almost, kind of, aren't they? No way.
I think in a way, yeah. I mean,
is that a new frame of mind surfacing there?
There's a tragedy involved in all of them, so yeah. I just read some early kind of reviews that We're in This Together has an unusually positive, and I didn't write it thinking it was very positive, and so I made a video that's very, very ugly to make sure it's, no one gets the wrong idea there.
There's at least one other relationship song on the album, and it appears to take some strong shots at Reznor's one-time friend, Marilyn Manson.
My God, I'm on the cover of the magazine. My God, I shout a little bit, trying to make this beat.
So Reznor and Nine Inch Nails are back at last, with no apparent regrets about how long it took to put this record together, or having wrapped it up too late to promote it at the recent semi-calamitous Woodstock Festival.
I mean, what do you think happened at Woodstock? I mean, you saw some of that on pay-per-view, right?
Well, I saw bits of it. I wasn't really aware of what was going on. I'd just see a performance here and there, and I was surprised when I saw it burning down. And later, when I found out about some of the conditions and prices and things like that, it seemed to make more sense. I had my own problems with watching that whole thing. It seemed to be a bit, so what? But I wasn't there, and I wasn't, you know, sleeping.
And does it worry you if somebody gets up on stage that there now seems to be okay to just throw stuff at people on stage, and you don't know what it's going to be, kind of winging in at you?
Yeah, I mean, it's a concern, and I think it's how we dealt with it. We got bombarded with sausages in Germany when we opened for Guns N' Roses. But I thought that was actually pretty funny. And deserved, I might add. But,
deserved?
We didn't belong in that bill.
Was that a not happy experience, touring with Guns N' Roses?
It was only a few dates, and, well, let me just put the bill this way. Us, Skid Row, Guns N' Roses.
Yeah. I think I see what you're saying.
Yeah. What was I thinking on that one?